Hi, my name's Ed Domino. I'm an active emeritus professor of pharmacology here at the University of Michigan Medical School. I want to talk to you today about something very exciting in the field of new ideas as to how to treat mental depression. There are current antidepressant agents. They do work, but the trouble is they don't work for as many patients as they should. We call such patients therapy or drug-resistant depressed patients. But the other reason is it takes too long. It'll take maybe a month or more on an antidepressant agent, of the, let's say, serotonin reuptake type as an example, before the patient gets any significant antidepressant effect. So there's a tremendous need to help people that have severe drug-resistant depression. And this is what I'd like to talk to you about today, because it turns out that on the horizon, some very new and exciting ideas have developed as a result of an agent which we call ketamine, or special K. If you look at Van Gogh's painting of worn out of a depressed patient, you can see how bad depression can be. All of us, depending upon how much stress we have, can handle the stress properly, or we can become extremely depressed. And ultimately, some of us who become so mentally depressed want to commit suicide. Ketamine is a very complicated drug. There's a right-hand form of it. There's a left-hand form of it. It's a tiger that needs to be controlled and very carefully, in fact. It has antidepressant effects, and it acts on the brain. And the key issue is, how and where does it act on the brain? This old drug is forcing us to discover many new brain mechanisms for its analgesic effects in low doses, where it reduces so-called neuronal windup. If you record from a pain neuron, you get a brrrp kind of a phenomenon in which the firing is initially low and then it increases, and under ketamine, the brrrp changes to brrrp, and the windup effect is reduced. It's an anesthetic agent in a special antagonism of a specific channel in low doses. This crazy drug is psychotomimetic. It causes schizophrenic-like symptoms. Would you believe it? Because it is in these low doses an antagonist of the receptor of glutamic acid, which is one of the most important excitatory transmitter in your brain and mine, acting on so-called NMDA receptor channels of the glutamic acid. It's obviously a very big drug of abuse, widely used in China, as I've said earlier, affecting NMDA antagonism. And now the new story is this rapid antidepressant effects, which come on shortly during the actual schizophrenomimetic story, and shortly thereafter, in a matter of minutes, within hours, you have a significant antidepressant effect. Can you imagine a person that's ready to commit suicide? You give them a dose of ketamine that's small, that produces dissociative or psychotomimetic symptoms, and within minutes to hours, that patient is almost normal, but only lasts for about a week or so, 2 weeks at the most, and they're back to their depression. So it's not a very long-acting agent, and it has to be repeated over and over again for it to get any significant effects. As a street drug, it's widely used throughout the world by many, many people under very special names. And in fact, special K is one that has been extremely popular in particular. Its effects on actions in the brain depend on what is the blood level and the blood levels in tiny amounts, these are billions of a gram, tiny amounts per mil of blood. And these low concentrations affect different actions, and depending on what they are, with high blood levels, as occurs with anesthesia, it displaces even more channels and actions within the brain to produce general anesthetic effect. And the key issue is in these dose-dependent actions of ketamine, since we're interested in this case in the rapid antidepressant effects, how does it act? Does it act through the mTOR system to increase synaptology or what? There are, in fact, many cons for the use of ketamine in anesthesia. Who wants to be having an emergence delirium when you come out of anesthesia under ketamine? And on the other hand, it's a very safe agent, and as a result, widely used in situations where there are not expert anesthesiologists or expert nurse anesthetists. One can, under emergency circumstances, for example, on a battlefield, ketamine can be given to wounded soldiers for its analgesic effects. Its status in ketamine, in anesthesia, the pros do outweigh the cons, but there are problems. Status in psychiatry is, at the moment, slightly pros versus its cons. No question, the big pro is its antidepressant effects that are rapid. Its cons related to the dissociative psychotomimetic effects, and its short-acting. And its status in the future, who knows where it'll be, but there are, at the moment, ketamine clinics all over the United States and pretty soon all over the world in terms of its use for serious drug-resistant depression. Future questions regarding ketamine's antidepressant effects are critical. And the most important is, why does low-dose ketamine work so rapidly? And the mechanisms are important to find that out. Will it be addicting if approved by the FDA on a prescription basis? And it's now being considered in terms of different routes of administration, by taking it orally or by taking it sniffing in the nose ketamine as a nasal spray. Is the right-hand form of ketamine better than its left-hand form? R versus left forms of ketamine. Will any of its metabolites be better? Because apparently some of these metabolites do not have, based on animal research, apparently significant excitatory or dissociative effects. And is there, and this is perhaps the more important, something new, far, far better and longer acting than ketamine? Because by studying in great detail the mechanisms, possible mechanisms of why ketamine increases synaptic contacts will be a direction for the future for its something that drug companies can develop far better than ketamine itself.